I'm Mike's mom. I'm the proud mother of Mike Watts. And welcome to Watts TV, everyone.
That was my mother. How about that? She's out here visiting us with my brother and my sister, and you'll see them on future videos. But right now, in honor of the International Women's Day, we are going to talk about women. So men, check in now. I know sometimes we like to check out when it comes to women, but we're going to check in and listen to what's up. So in my industry, in the direct sales, I build a business in the network marketing industry, but it's also part of direct sales. In the direct sales industry, the amount of people that are out of 100% of people in the direct sales industry, 85.2% are women, which is a great thing for us guys sometimes, because especially you get to hang out with women all the time. So I always wonder why there's not more men, especially single dudes, in this industry, because they can find really good women. Over the course of the past couple weeks, I've talked to a lot of women because we've been generating a lot of leads once we launched Kate's mentoring program. To check out Kate's mentoring program, I'll put a link in the description of this video. But through that, I've realized a couple things that all of a sudden a woman will be super excited about it. She'll be like, okay, can I think about this? I want to just kind of take a little breather to think about things, and because a lot of information has happened very fast to process. Completely understand. So they go off, they start processing, they go talk to their partner, usually a guy, and next thing you know, it's coming back, ooh, me and my partner talked about this, and we just don't think it's the right thing for us to do at this point in time. Or, ew, we don't think this is good for me at this point. So I start thinking to myself, how can someone go from super pumped up to something and then talk to their partner and their energy level just go, a lot comes from the woman doesn't know how to explain that to her partner. So, and then the guy who doesn't want to talk to me or doesn't want to talk to somebody else about to find out more information, they just shut it down immediately. So there's three things that men out there can do to support their woman, since it's International Ladies Day, how to support your women even more into the future. Three tips, and I'll talk strictly men to women here in this relationship because that's what I've been around for the past 2 weeks, but find out what your woman really wants to do. Find out what your partner really wants. I know she doesn't want to just have babies and sit at home and cook all the time. There's something else in life that is driving her, and my mom's sitting over going, so there's something else in life that is driving her and things that she wants to accomplish. So if you don't know what those are, how can you support her to be able to do that? And I know this is a question we don't ask other people in relationships at all. So how is it that you could support her to achieve what she wants to do? What is it she wants to do in life? Because her dream, there is some women out there that their dream is this, but most women are not, want to find some guy, get married, have kids, and then stay at home and cook and clean and do whatever else the rest of their life. Guarantee that's not what they want to do. So find out what they really, truly are passionate about and what they want to do in life and help them achieve that. Number two, whether it's looking at a business or whether it's in life and they're making decisions, could be like, landscaping the front yard or doing something interior of the house, changing the furniture around, adding paint. Trust what they're going to do is right. Okay, because a lot of times is that we'll just say, why did you go buy that? Why are you doing that? What is going on? This isn't the way I wanted it. Trust what they're doing is correct. And if you step back and say, why did you go out there and add that bush to that position? And why is it there? Like, if you really look at it, it probably looks pretty good. So have a little faith in what your partner is going to be able to do, make decisions. Because as a man, we're big macho men and we're going to solve the world's problems. Luckily, the world is in a dire strait of needs and it's run by men. So that is not the correct situation, and not everything that we do as a man is, I know we're grown to take care of women. Like, we have to take care of her and take care of the house and take care of the family. But honestly, it's a two-person relationship, and then if you have children in there, it's even more. So it's got to be balanced in there. So each of you have to take care of her, and she's got to take care of you. So you have to figure out how to balance that. So trust her in that relationship of what she's doing to make the right decision. So number three thing I have for you is be a little bit spontaneous. We have these traditional holidays that are Valentine's Day and International Women's Day, and we're going to honor them all on these certain days. What about the rest of the year? That's 363 days left. Be spontaneous. I know one of the most successful things I've seen in successful relationships is the spontaneity that's there. Is the guy brings different things home, surprises you with something. The woman brings something home, surprises the man with something. And number one, guys, with gifts, don't buy your women appliances. They don't want a new washing machine or a stupid refrigerator, okay? Check it out. If the refrigerator's broken, go buy one. Not because get it for, oh, hey, happy Wednesday, I bought you a refrigerator. No, you're an idiot. That's your food in there. So let's be spontaneous. Flowers, things that women like. If you really understand what your woman wants in life, you're gonna understand what she likes. Don't wait for these special holidays to buy certain presents or like say, hey, I love you on this day. What about every single other day? Happy International Ladies Day. I support you. I've hung out with thousands of women over the last year, especially when I've been traveling with Kate, and all of them are making things happen, starting businesses, running things, changing things up. It's just so much growth happening, and I know it's a little bit intimidating for the man, is especially like the woman is a big wig here, and she's making things happen, and the guy's like, oh, they kind of cradle up. So definitely be powerful, and if you have a partner at home, sit him down and be like, watch this bald dude for a little bit, because he's got some good points. So have a great rest of the day, guys, and I'll talk to you soon. Bye.